Hey everyone, how's it going? Now, here's something I did not expect today, but this is important. Shintaro Furukawa actually talks about the idea of new Switch hardware and the future of the Switch platform and how Nintendo approaches things. And this is important because while we have heard Nintendo's approach to new generations, console development, game development over the years, that was under, you know, Satoru Iwata, may he rest in peace, and obviously Kimishima, who was a temporary stand-in until Shintaro Furukawa was ready. Now, Shintaro Furukawa has not actually spoken very often outside of investors' meetings, so to see this interview happen is huge. It happened with popular Japanese publication Nikkei, but it's been translated and put out there by Kotaku. So let's actually give this a read, because it's pretty interesting what he had to say. So the article goes, the Nintendo Switch was launched on March 3rd, 2017. Just as the console passes the four-year point, Nintendo President Shintaro Furukawa discusses the hardware and its lifespan in a new interview with Nikkei Business. For our company, it's a big topic what we should do next when a console passes its fifth year, which, by the way, it hasn't passed its fifth year yet, but it's in the midst of its fifth year. As of today, or as of yesterday, whatever. Anyways, going on. And the hardware's life cycle is in the process of getting longer, Furukawa explained. The exec added that great care is given to Switch owners who are continuing to use the console. Nikkei Business did not ask the exec about the recent Switch design rumors. I mean, let's be honest, he would just give the same response that he has nothing to say anytime soon. But the interview does shed light into how Nintendo develops new hardware and the company's approach to innovation. The publication did point out that depending on how things are handled, the console's lifespan can get even longer. That's correct, Furukawa replied, regarding the Switch's lifespan. I often say that's entered in the middle phase or so. He explained that because the Switch can be played as a traditional home console and as a portable, there are a lot of possible games. We are able to lengthen the life cycle. Furukawa was asked about the development timeframes for hardware, to which he replied, we are always doing research and development. According to Furukawa, the hardware and software dev teams are in the same building and are in close communication. Therefore, they are always able to come up with new ideas and proposals. Because you must do all sorts of various preparations to make one new console, the truth is that you cannot stop. Ultimately, the deciding factor as to whether or not something becomes an actual product is whether or not it creates a new experience. But even though the first few years of Switch have been wildly successful, Furukawa isn't complacent. Currently, the Switch's sales are exceedingly favorable, and achievements are also good, but I have zero peace of mind, he said. No matter the hits in the entertainment business, people someday do lose interest. Up until now, we have repeatedly had the experience of our business taking a nosedive. Because of this, I myself, as well as those within the company, do not at all think that the current state of affairs will keep going and going. For Furukawa, he believes that every single year is a do-or-die situation. You must give new customers fresh surprises, and our existence can slip into obscurity at any time. I have always had this kind of sense of crisis. Now look, at this point, you could try to read between the tea leaves, which I'm about to do, but it's clear that Shintaro Furukawa never is satisfied. This is a very different take than Satoru Iwata and even Kimishima before him, where maybe they rest on their laurels a little bit, get a little bit complacent, and we see that at times. He's kind of like, no, look, any time, at any point, he's been with Nintendo a long time, something can change drastically, and the company nosedives. That's just the way the industry has gone for Nintendo. You have massive successes like Wii DS, massive failures like Wii U. 3DS isn't technically a failure, but it's the least selling handheld system to date. Obviously, they saw, you know, huge success with NES and Game Boy, even Game Boy Advance, and then kind of saw things peter off a little bit, with N64 and then GameCube. So clearly, like, he's seen the ebbs and flows of Nintendo, and what he wants to do is make it so the ebbs and flows, you know, that he does feel are a little bit inevitable are less likely to occur, less likely to nose dive, and that they won't bring out a new product, of course, a new generation of systems, unless it's ready to do something that surprises and invigorates the consumer. And I think what's interesting is when he mentions that every single year for him is do or die, he doesn't look at any particular year as we could take this year off, we can just chill, which is interesting because a lot of people think that's exactly what Nintendo did last year. But if you think about it, consider this. They went into the year with the work from home mandate, went into the year, obviously, with manufacturing a significantly cut back on Switch, and went into the year knowing that they were not going to be able to deliver the kind of lineup that they would like to. There was going to be game delays. But what did Nintendo do? They didn't just accept that there was going to be game delays. They ended up delivering what I feel is actually ended up being a really good year of games. And yes, Animal Crossing New Horizons clearly was the big thing that carried it, but Super Mario 3D All-Stars sold over 8 million. You have Age of Calamity selling over 3.5 million, probably over 4 million at this point. You know, you had Paper Mario selling a lot. You had even Xenoblade Chronicles Definitive Edition selling a lot. Pikmin 3 Deluxe becoming the best-selling Pikmin game of all time. Clearly, while there was a heavy reliance maybe on older content last year, it still worked out. Nintendo didn't just bail on the year and not give people stuff to play, even if what they were playing was basically rehashes of games that have already been out beyond a couple experiences. So Nintendo was definitely still trying to be successful and not just accepting, hey, we're gonna have like the Wii lulls, you know, we're gonna have those years with Wii where we only have like two games come out. No. Like, even if we don't have massive exclusives, we're going to bring back some of our older content and make it fresh and make it good for you guys again. And that was Nintendo's approach to last year. And obviously, the very beginning of this year, up until, obviously, Bravely Default 2 came out, Monster Hunter Rise, new Pokemon Snap, all that jazz. Obviously, Skyward Sword HD is a little bit of a continuation of that. However, probably leading into Zelda 35th anniversary stuff. It's interesting because Furukawa, with this attitude of do or die, with this attitude of trying to keep things going, trying to keep things going and going and going, but this kind of lends credence to bringing something like a Switch Pro to the marketplace because Nintendo has traditionally let their systems kind of peter out. Wii U petered out. Wii petered out, you know? GameCube petered out. N64 petered out. 3DS petered out. Like, Nintendo kind of rides and dies with the system until it's just not selling anymore. And then at that point, they've already lost all their sales momentum, and now they're kind of stuck trying to rebuild. He doesn't want to get Nintendo into that position. By viewing every single year with Nintendo as a do or die, by doing, in his own words, because of this, I myself, as well as those within the company, do not at all think that the current state of affairs keep going and going, and that every is a do or die, and you must constantly give customers new, fresh surprises, and our existence can slip into obscurity at any time. Like, he has this kind of sense of crisis about him. Those are his words. Like, to him, Nintendo's always in crisis. That's good. That is why you bring a Switch Pro to the marketplace, despite the fact that the Switch is killing it. Because to ignore that you could provide a better experience to gamers, to make new Switch owners happy, to make original Switch owners happier, to ignore that would just to be getting complacent, to just accept, hey, the Switch is killing it right now. Why do anything new? Because if you don't, you get complacent. You don't wait. You don't do what Nintendo's been doing for so long, which is wait until your system isn't relevant and then try to make it relevant again. That's not what you do. In Nintendo's ideal world with Switch, they come out with a Switch Pro this year. It maintains momentum, maybe even builds it higher than it's ever been. And then by the time that gets to its peak, right? Give it two years or so. When that gets to its peak, that's when you start to reinvigorate that market with the idea of a new platform. A Switch 2. You keep the momentum going for as long as you can. And he's realistic. Yeah, the Switch idea isn't going to work forever. But why not try to make it work for as long as possible? Why not try to keep the market excited for it for as long as possible with the content and with the hardware? It's a synergy. He mentions, hey, we have the hardware team and the software teams in the same building. There is a synergy. If the software teams tell the hardware team, hey, look, we need an upgrade. We want to make our games better. We want Breath of the Wild 2 to be 60 FPS. Native 1080p. What can you do to do that without alienating the old consumer base? A mid-gen upgrade like the new 3DS is like exactly what they need to do. People were bitching back then. Back then, when Xenoblade Chronicles was exclusive, you know, when Minecraft came out and was exclusive to the new 3DS, people were bitching then. And you know what happened? The new 3DS became the best-selling 3DS platform. You don't think Nintendo would love the idea of the Switch Pro leading the charge as the best-selling Switch platform? Do you think they'd love to sell 90 million of the current Switches and then 100 million of Switch Pros? Of course they would. And if they can keep it going for 3-4 years because of the Switch Pro, then absolutely. Nintendo wants to keep momentum. They don't want to wait till momentum is gone and then try to win it back. It is so hard to do that. And I think he learned this from watching Sony. Sony has been the masters of never letting momentum die. Okay? They screwed it up once. PlayStation 3 launch messed it up. Way too expensive. The wrong technology made the wrong bets. Blu-ray was the right bet. The weird architecture of the system was the wrong bet. And they paid the price for it. And it took them years and years to build the reputation back up. Nintendo doesn't want to do that anymore. They've been there. They've done that. They want to look at what Sony does. PlayStation 4 sold 20 plus million units in its final year before PlayStation 5 came out. 20 plus million! Nintendo wants that. Don't, like, everyone's like, why replace a system, you know, with a new system when the old system is still selling so well? So the momentum doesn't go away. Yeah, PlayStation 4 sales are going to drop off a cliff now. Doesn't matter because PlayStation 5 is killing it in the marketplace. That's what Nintendo wants. They want Switch and then the next gen and then they want everything to be smooth. They don't want to have lulls. They know the lulls happen, but they want to do what they can to avoid it. Having this do or die attitude is going to keep Nintendo constantly pushing the envelope, not only with technology, but with their games. This is good news. This is absolutely good news. Even if you're personally not excited for a Pro, you're perfectly happy with your Switch. Guess what? Pretty much, you know, I just put up a video that the Switch Pro will have exclusives because every single, like, new revision, not revision, more powerful revision, I should put out there, of a handheld system for Nintendo has had exclusive games in combination with a report out there that third parties are going to be doing exclusive games. Guess what? That's third party. Nintendo themselves are not going to take like Metroid Prime 4 or Bayonetta 3 or Breath of the Wild 2 and say, guess what? You have to buy a Switch Pro to play it. No, it might be best on Switch Pro, but you'll still be able to play it. They're not going to leave that audience behind. What was something they said? You know, trying to do these things while not alienating the audience. You can do this. Basically, Nintendo can win across the board with the Switch Pro if they approach it just right. And that's what I'm getting out of this. You could say I'm just reading what I want from the tea leaves, and that is totally fine. You tell me what you think. Obviously, I feel like this do or die thing from Nintendo is like, yes. Yes. Like, this is what I've been wanting from them. I've been wanting them to not get complacent. And this is a non-complacent Nintendo. That's exciting. So you guys let me know what you think about this down in the comments below. I am Nathaniel Robojets from Nintendo Pride. Got my shout out to Ninjala. Obviously, I thought it was better at E3, but you know what? Ninjala, the final product, is still a pretty good game. I, you know, if you haven't given it a try, it is completely free to play and exclusive to Switch, so you absolutely should check it out. They're not a sponsor or anything. It's just, I think it's a legitimately good game, so go check it out. Otherwise, I will catch you guys tonight. I want to see you guys back here around 8 p.m. Central Time. If you're watching this later, then sorry you missed it, but you can go back and rewatch it. I will be doing a live stream tonight. We'll be streaming Breath of the Wild, also a Q&A, so it's going to be kind of a combo conversation and gameplay stream. And for every 100 live viewers, there will be giveaways, and the giveaways will get bigger and bigger and bigger the more we get. So, like, the first 100 viewers will be, like, you know, an eShop gift card, 200 will be something, 300, 400. Maybe we get to 1,000, maybe we give away a Switch. I have no idea. We're just going to kind of let it be escalating giveaway. So there you go. Thank you guys so much for tuning in. We'll see what happens tonight. I'm looking forward to having a lot of fun with all of you. Peace out.